tonight on Lizard Lick Towing.
I'm gonna tell you what, cuz.
When a repo in town goes bad, Ron and Bobby's friendship is on the rocks.
You left me by myself. I can get home by myself.
I didn't leave you, man.
I'm done.
And when Amy reveals a big secret.
And how long have you known this without telling me?
Lizard Lick is going to get turned upside down.
Y'all are like a bunch of dramatic girls. Ronnie, phone.
This is Ron. How can I help you?
Hey, Ron. My name is Jim, Bulldog Recovery. And I've got a case that we've been having trouble with. And to be flat out honest with you, it's going to be a dangerous case. The one guy that I've got that I thought could handle this case ran into him at a biker bar, and all of his buddies just beat the tar out of him. I'll pay what I got to pay because I just need this car.
All right. Go ahead and send me everything you got on this guy, and we'll locate your car for you, bud.
I appreciate it, buddy.
Thank you, sir.
All right, bye-bye.
You know, Ronnie, you really need to start thinking about being more careful.
What?
I just think that there comes a point in time where you should just be a little more cautious with what you do.
Are you taking some new herbal medication or something?
I don't take medications. Just saying.
Come on, Bobby. What the world's wrong with you today, Amy?
Did you have some seafood? Because you sound crabby.
Shut up.
This guy's pulled over 10 years of time. Free debt. That mug straight out of prison, Bo. Well, maybe we can get some background on this cat, Bo. Okay, let's go into artist. Dude, look at this right here, son. Started tattooing when I was 13. He's learned a lot about life through lessons that were learned hard, including spending many years in the state penitentiary. Let's go when we think this boy will be in the chair. That way we ain't even got to see him or deal with him.
Sounds good to me.
These boys might be tough, son, but don't mean they're the toughest.
We're getting ready to introduce them to a whole new type.
A bad to the bone.
We're going to get the car, you know that. If we come to get it, we're going to get it.
You know, this repo is going to be so easy. We're going to roll into town and hit the garage, and we won't even have to talk to the big, bad tattoo guy because he's going to be busy working next door.
This is a Grand Am GT. The color is supposed to be aqua.
10-4, Mr. Aqua Green.
That's it right there, bud. That's the tattoo parlor.
I got a Grand Am.
Green in color.
Oh, yeah, baby. That's going to be our
boy.
Came back right up to it, son. He parked
it right where you want it.
This is what I'm talking about. Boy, I'm happy in a shoe flying an outhouse. Man, his e-brakes up, B.
Shoot. It's locked up tight.
I could have just left. But that ain't the kind of guy I am. Now, this guy may be tough, but I don't scare that easy. So I guess I gotta confront him and see if I can get a key from him.
I hear him tatting somebody now.
What's up, fellas? How y'all doing tonight?
What can we do for y'all?
We're looking for John Savage.
What y'all doing here, man?
I'm out here to get your car, buddy.
I ain't taking no damn car from up here. I ain't tell you that.
We ain't trying to be polite. Dude, I got papers on your car. I'm already hooked up to the car, dude.
No, man, that's crap right there.
Check on my car and make sure they ain't messing with me. No, look, Bo. I'm already hooked up to your car. Hold on, Bo.
I ain't got no beef with you, fellas.
What the way y'all come
here? We're looking for
you. Go outside.
Some fuck with you.
It's already strapped down, man. Get up!
Take it off.
I ain't taking nothing off.
Take it off.
Oh, come back.
Take it, man.
Bobby, where you at? B, come on, man.
Come on, get you. You want some?
Hey, can I get an ambulance, please?
You want some?
I'm a Savage and Hez tattoo parlor.
Give me an ambulance. I ain't got time to talk. Just give me an ambulance out here. Bobby, I got an ambulance on the way, dude.
Bo, you better get out of here right now.
Hope that car was working.
I'm
I'm going home.
Come on, B.
I ain't got no pain.
You need to have an x-ray of your head.
I need a shoe, and I'm going home.
You sure you don't have any other pain?
No pain.
Check your back again.
I ain't got no pain. Yeah, I need a shoe.
You go. I just recommend you go.
All right?
Yeah.
Let me drive you out of here, man.
You gonna come repossess something else, man? Huh?
Right. B, where you going? Let me drive you to the hospital.
You left me by myself. I can get home by myself.
You leave me by yourself, dude. Let me drive you to the hospital.
You left me by myself. I can get home by myself.
I didn't leave you, man. I don't want anybody here like
that. I'm done.
Bobby, man, I didn't leave you, dog. I swear, man. I went outside after the guy with the keys, man. I thought everything was cool. I had no idea you won't follow me out.
You're lying. You left me, and I'm done with you.
You didn't feel like it.
Next.
Amy, call Bobby.
Why?
The guys from the tattoo parlor outside.
Man, answer the phone, dude.
If you feel like it, leave a message.
Hey, B, man, I've left you like 5 messages. Bo, if you could, please call me back, man. Bo. Can't get in touch with Bob.
So that's why you look like you lost your best friend?
I might have lost my best friend.
Ron and Bobby get into this sort of fight all the time. It's just a question of which one of them thinks that their friendship's more important first before they end this madness.
Well, I told you not to take that job anyway. You didn't listen to me, so you know what? I'm done with the situation. Sorry.
You know what, man? You're about as caring as a freaking dead cat.
Hey, I got a quarter. Call somebody who cares.
What in the world was that? Amy, call Bobby.
Why?
The guys from the tattoo parlor are outside.
Okay.
The interference.
If you feel like it, leave a message.
Don't, man, don't be hit by cars, man.
How's it feel to have somebody in your house? Where you going now, big boy?
Y'all better go on. I'm telling you now. Y'all need to get out of here. Shut the doors. Amy, they're crazy, I'm telling you, honey. Amy, they're coming in.
This was a really scary situation. Most of the time, more testosterone in a room is not the solution. A lot of guys won't touch a woman, so I decided to get to work.
I don't think y'all need to be up in here hollering. No, I don't think You tell all your buddies to step outside, and I'll let my owner come out and talk to you. Y'all can talk man to man.
No, man. We don't need no police. I need your car. We'll tell every car in here. Here's what you need to worry about, dude. You
what I need to worry about?
My tattoo shop, running your mouth, messing with my business. Now, they're out of here. It's just me and you.
And that's it's pretty obvious, Bo, that all that ink is going to your head. And no, I understand, Bo. I understand.
Your head.
What's that
all you got, Bo? Let's see what you got.
I
need to call him off. Hey, no, let's see what you got. That's cool.
I got it.
I need to call him off. What do you have in there?
I got it. I'll call him right now.
Now who you gonna call, man?
It ain't so easy.
Now
you gonna need that.
Come back up there again and try to take something from somebody.
You wanna go to prison over a stupid car, man?
They're outside right
there
now.
There you go, bro. Go take a look at your ride.
You know, this guy was on probation, and the last thing he needed was to get arrested over a stupid car. Now, I didn't want to press charges, but he needed to learn a lesson. He needed to understand that he damaged my property and my friend, and he was going to pay me back somehow.
Look at you. All the talent you got, and you're going to waste it over a stupid car. Think about that, Bo.
What are you going to do about the police? You need to get him out of here.
What you going to do about all this money you cost me?
I'll work something out with you. I'll make it right. Hook you up with some artwork, but tell that man to leave.
Go out your door and tell that officer we're sorry. It was a false call. And better live.
I appreciate that.
I'll call you. We're done.
I'm out.
We're
done.
Tell people you
won't
get tattooed.
The last thing I want is a tattoo, but you want me to take less chances, so I try to work out a deal.
You already went up in there in the freaking bee's nest last night and started all the trouble you needed to.
The man owes me $700-$800. He's come up here and just chased me in my own place.
Well, you know what?
Inside.
I ain't gonna ask you whose fault it is because you look at it in the mirror every day.
I wish you'd just listen to me. He takes too many chances, and I worry about Ronnie's judgment sometimes.
What you doing?
No, I'm just tired. I don't feel good.
I got an idea. Why don't you come to my ball game tonight?
Oh, yes. That's exactly what I want to do.
It'll make you feel better, babe. Come on, go to the game with me.
Okay, fine. Whatever.
Can you give me a kiss at least?
No.
All right. Well, we'll have fun tonight. I sure hope he's there. I mean, this is the grudge match. You don't think he'll show up for the championship game, baby?
I don't know.
Ronnie and Bobby like to blow steam by playing softball against each other. They've been doing it for 15 years, but this was especially huge because it was the championship.
I'll be standing right there. Watch this. Good luck, B. You ain't gonna speak? You gonna say hey? Yeah, that mug ain't gonna speak.
I was there to play ball, bottom line, not to make up with Ronnie. If he was there to smooth things over, I wasn't. I was just there to win the game.
Y'all ready to play ball?
Yes, come on.
Come on, y'all, make it.
Awesome. Y'all want some more of that?
Come on now, don't make me walk, bro. At least give me something to swing at.
But I'm gonna give it to you.
Your backside.
It was the bottom of the ninth. Bases were loaded. All I needed was a hit to win. And, man, I was hoping to rub Ronnie's nose in it.
All right, one out. We got it, y'all. One out. We got it. Right here. What in the world was that, dude?
Ball game.
Well, they won't have needed that in first place.
Ball game.
They won't have needed that crap, man. I don't care how big it is.
That's ball game.
They don't need that. They don't need that, boy. Hold on. They don't need that. Back on your back.
Like I said, ball game.
All right, man. Y'all are friends, man. Come on.
Ronnie, it ain't worth it. That's ridiculous. It's a ball game.
That ain't just a ball game.
I mean, y'all are taking y'all's anger level from something else.
That's
to
the whole
a ball
point.
Game.
We're
That's
to a
what
ball
I'm
game.
Saying. It's not okay, but it's better just to leave it alone. It ain't worth it. It ain't worth it.
You should go over there and...
I ain't going over there, pig.
Hey, did you have a good time? Well,
y'all are like a bunch of dramatic girls.
Coming up...
Well, why don't you think about this then?
And how long have you known this without telling me?
Hey, have you heard from Bobby?
No, I ain't heard from Bobby. And to tell you the truth, Amy, I don't care if I ever hear from Bobby again.
Oh, my God. Could you please make up with Bobby? Enough is enough, and I need him today.
Why?
I don't feel good, and I'm going to a doctor's appointment.
Well, I got an errand I got to run too, Amy.
Well, call Bobby and ask him if he can come in.
Baby, you got a better chance of winning the lottery without buying a ticket than me calling Bobby Brantley.
Oh, my gosh, you're acting so childish. Fine, I'll go call him myself.
That's
good Lord.
The only way you're going to get in touch with him. Amy can get Bobby back to work if she wants to. But after last night's ball game, I'm done with him. I got to roll, baby. I hope you feel better. Good luck at the doctor. I love you. Look who that is.
Ass.
Oh, great, you're here. All right, I shouldn't be for about 2 hours. I'll be back.
Let's see if I can pull up some porn.
Yeah.
Yeah, I need to speak to somebody, please. How you doing? My name is Jerome. I done walked over here half a mile after getting the bus, after y'all done picked up and towed my car. One of y'all got my medicine, man. I need my medicine, please.
I understand that, but I can't do nothing for you till you give me some ID.
I need my medicine.
I don't care what you do. You act like you have some sense.
You can do whatever you want, man. I don't care.
What you gonna do?
What?
I didn't know what kind of medication this guy was looking for, but he obviously needed something.
Yo, man, he does. I sit right here like it's in jail.
You know what, boy? He's about to have a really bad day. You understand me? I told you. I ain't playing with you no more. And first thing you're gonna do, you gonna get up, you gonna clear up this mess. Do you understand me? Give me your identification.
Nice and clean now.
I couldn't believe the guy just handed me his ID. If he'd have done that 5 minutes beforehand, I wouldn't have had to get rough with him, and the office wouldn't have got torn up.
See, it's that one right there with all the hearts on it.
You want what's in that car?
Yes, sir. I want my medicine.
That's what you wanted. NyQuil.
Yeah, I needed my medicine, man.
That's all you wanted.
Thank you very much. I thank you.
Bobby, what happened in here?
It's a long story.
Y'all done tore up the whole
office. Not y'all, nothing. Happened. I got a date. You done with me?
You got a date? Where are you going?
I got somewhere nice.
Well, thank you for leaving me for the mess to clean up.
Have a good evening.
I appreciate that. Oh, my God. I will never let him run my office again.
You know, I don't want to tell Amy, but I'm going to go back over here to this tattoo shop where we repoed the car the other night. I'm taking a big risk going back in this guy's place, but I'm hoping this guy's a man of his word, and he's going to do what he said he's going to do, and I'm going to come out of here with some real hot ink.
Now, he is crazy, but he's also the baddest artist for miles around, and there's a piece I really wanted.
What's going on, fellas? I thought I might come by and talk to you about a little deal we had discussed. You serious about it?
Yeah, I don't like it.
Well, I ain't trying to deal with the police.
We do this, everything's squashed. We're even.
We'll be cool.
All right, let's talk tattoos then, brother. I just hope Amy likes it. But you know what? Even if she don't, ain't a whole lot she can do about it now. Off the chamber. Surprise Amy with my new ink.
Hey! Ace for horses, buy a donkey.
I got something for you to look at.
What? What have you gone and done?
That's my customized Lizzie Lick logo.
Let me get this straight. You gonna go get a tattoo from a guy that beat up Bobby? Beat up your own buddy.
You knew the guy wasn't gonna give me the money, honey. You're making mountains out of molehills right now.
I am not. I'm acting like an adult, thinking about the spectrum of things. I ain't thinking about putting ink on my body.
That's fine. You sit here and think about it by yourself, because I'm done listening to you today.
You ain't done listening to me.
I'm done.
You're done when I tell you that you're done listening to me.
I don't know who you're talking to.
I'm talking to you.
Well, you keep on talking. I've heard about all I want to hear, Amy. It's like it's nonstop with you.
Well, why don't you think about this then? I'm pregnant. So maybe that's why I'm a little moody.
And how long have you known this without telling me?
Well, you're over there blowing your haystack.
Baby, I don't know why in the world you ain't just said you're pregnant. Why ain't you telling me to begin with?
Because I wanted to be sure before I said anything.
The last few days have pretty much been hell on earth. But as soon as Amy told me she was pregnant, it's like nothing else seemed to matter.
Hey, if you have a little boy, can we get a Lizzie Lick tattoo on?
No.
I wish you had told me though, seriously. Give me a kiss. I love you.
After Amy told me the great news, I just couldn't wait to share it with all the people that are closest to me.
I have got to go tell Bobby. I'm going to run over to Bobby. Get your stuff. Let's run over to Bobby's house.
You can't go to Bobby's house.
Why can't I go to Bobby's house?
Even though we're on a date.
What do you mean he's on a date?
He's on a date.
He tell you if he was going to get something to
eat? He did say he was going to get something to eat, yes.
You know what you call a deal, won't I?
What?
An idea. And I got one. Get your stuff. Come on.
You got an idea.
I got an idea. Get your stuff. Trust me. Get your stuff. Come on.
Oh, my God.
Just come
Ronnie,
on.
Ronnie, your ideas always turn out to bite me in the end.
Baby, this one right here is going to be gooder than grits.
Coming up.
Say it ain't so.
Yes, it is so.
That's why she's been so, like, hormonal and stuff.
I know Bobby better than Moses knew the desert. He's got champagne taste with a flat beer pocketbook. Ain't but two places that boy will go out to eat on a date, and I know both of them. This right here is gonna be right fun.
I really want to make up with Bobby. And since he and I are big practical jokers, I thought maybe if I could get him laughing, I can get him back on my side. And I had a great idea how to do that.
Baby, what you see sitting right on it?
That would be his truck.
You think? All right, hold on now. This is great.
He's going to love this. Dave's probably going to be like, did your car get repossessed?
Yeah. She's going to be done with Bobby tonight. That's it for her. Oh, is that Bobby?
Oh.
Who just walked around? Somebody just walked in front of the building. You see?
Where's my truck?
Is that Bobby?
I don't know. My truck was right there.
Look.
his hands are going.
Yeah, Lauren thinks he got jacked.
Oh, she's leaving.
Where are you going?
I'm gonna find my way home. You don't have a car.
Go on. Go on.
I don't know where she's going, but she's a welcome boy.
You get a ride home, let me know.
He ain't seen me yet. Let me cut my lights on.
Hey, look, you ain't gonna believe this right here, bud.
Howdy, Daisy. Where's your date?
And y'all all think this is funny. This ain't funny.
Our present.
You can't be mad at me no
I
more,
bud.
Bo, I just gotta say it. You just been licked.
But it ain't.
You gotta forgive me, bro. I'm sorry.
I ain't got to.
I really don't believe you, bro.
Yeah, you guys need to hash things out. Bobby, I have some news for you.
Well, yeah.
I'm pregnant.
Say it ain't so.
Yes, it is so.
That's why she's been so, like, hormonal and stuff.
When Amy told me she was pregnant, I couldn't be angry anymore. So I forgave Ronnie for her sake. Well, yeah, that, I did get a pretty good lick in on the softball game. So I guess we're even.
I love you. This ain't funny,
Bobby. This is funny. But now you know why we've been having the problems we've been having, Bobby.
Well, she's been hormonal.
I'm just telling y'all now that no more dangerous repos, right? We can agree on this.
Bobby, let's be easier, man. Let's be easier. Let's just take it easy.
Oh,
now.
No doubt. We get pregnant. We can't have no stress. I'm down with that.
You got it.
Okay. Well, look, waddle on back to the truck. And try not to peel yourself. I'll see you tomorrow.
Maybe you can go find your date.